In today's video, we're going to take a look at what's new in the Calendar app and the Reminders app on the iPad with iPadOS 18. Probably the biggest thing is we can now view our reminders within the Calendar app itself. Not only can we view them, but we can also edit them and even create them. Now, before we get started, if you like what you see, if you find it helpful, make sure you stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at what's new with the Calendar and Reminders apps on the iPad with iPadOS 18. Now, the first thing we're going to look at is how we can go and add reminders to the Calendar app. We can do this basically two different ways. We can do this from the Reminders app itself by adding a date, or we can do it through the Calendar app. Let's first take a look at how this works with the Reminders app. So I'm going to tap on Reminders here. And what I need to do is create a new reminder. So I'm just going to tap on New Reminder here. Nothing new here. Works just like it did before. But the key here is when I add a date to this, what it's going to do is it's going to add it to my calendar based on that date. So I have to put together a desk chair. So I'm just going to put this in here, desk chair. And right now it's just a simple reminder. It is not going to be in my calendar app. But when I go and tap on the I here to go and add a date, when I add the date, we're just going to keep it at today. What it's going to do is it's going to add it to my calendar automatically based on that date. And that's basically all we have to do. Now, not only will it add that reminder, but also you'll be able to see all of this information within the Calendar app itself. So basically what we're able to do, as long as it has a date, is just use the Calendar app for our reminders. So let's see what this looks like. So now let's go back over to my Calendar app, or let's go over to my Calendar app. We haven't been in there yet. So I tap on Calendar, and what you're going to see here is put together the desk chair. It is on today here. Let's go ahead and go to today so we can easily see this. And when I go up to the top here, you're going to see it says put together desk chair. Now, if I want to mark this as complete, it is a to-do. I just tap on it, and then I can go and mark it as complete. And when I mark it as complete, it will mark it as complete in the Reminders app as well. If I wanted to view it in the Reminders app, I can do that as well. But instead of viewing it in the Reminders app, let's say I wanted to edit it, I can also just tap on Edit here. And when I do, I can go and edit that reminder. And any changes I make here will also show up in the Reminders app. So I'm able to edit it, mark it as complete, and if I wanted to delete it, I could delete it from here as well, and it'll be deleted on the Reminders app. Now that's one way of doing that. What we can do is just add it through the Reminders app and add a date. But we can also add a reminder through the Calendar app. This is also something new. So to do that, what we do is we go back over to our Calendar app, and then we tap on the plus here. And when I tap on the plus, you're going to see that I have the option for Reminder. So now I tap on that, and you're going to see I have all of the information. I can even go and change the list. Now, when I do add a reminder here, it is going to put a date on there because I'm in the Calendar app. So we can't just put generic reminders in the Calendar app. It does have to have a date. And when I go and do add a reminder in here, it will add it to the Reminders app as well. So it keeps them in sync with each other. Now, if you don't like this behavior, you can turn this off. You can hide your reminders from your Calendar app. How do we do that? Well, basically, it's just another calendar through the Reminders app. What do I mean by that? Well, let's go back over to my calendar. And then what we need to do is we need to tap on the little calendar icon. This is where you can view all of our different calendars within the Calendar app. So now I just tap on it. Here are all my calendars, and when we swipe up, you're going to see that we have Other, and under Other, we have Scheduled Reminders. So all I have to do is just tap on that check mark for Scheduled Reminders to hide it. I tap on it, so the check mark disappears, and you're going to see that they are no longer showing here. The reminders aren't. I want to show them again. All I have to do is just tap on it again, and now we can see we have our reminders in there. So if you don't like that behavior, you can also just hide them. It doesn't actually delete them, it just hides them. Now, if you do not see this, what I've seen is if you don't see that, that means that you don't have any reminders that are scheduled. So just go ahead and schedule a reminder, put a date in there, and then all of a sudden you'll see this. At least in my experience, this is how it works. All right, the last thing I want to show you is we now can recover deleted reminders. This is within the Reminders app itself. So now what we need to do is we need to go over to the Reminders app. So let's go back over to my iPad, and then we tap on Reminders here. And if I wanted to delete a reminder, all I have to do is just swipe over to the left. So let's just go ahead and delete that. In the past, when I deleted a reminder, it was gone. You couldn't recover it. You could always mark a reminder as complete and incomplete and recover that. But if you deleted a reminder, it was gone. Well, now you're going to see that we have a recently deleted list here. And when I tap on recently deleted, I can see all of my recently deleted reminders. So now all I need to do is just tap on this to recover it. It's going to come up with a dialog box. I hit recover, and now that is recovered. When you do that, it does not put it into the original list. It keeps a lot of the same information, like that had a due date on it. It kept that due date, but it did not keep it in the original list. If this was originally in, let's say, an Aaron, what it's going to do is put it back in my default mailbox, or I'm sorry, my default reminders list. So what it's going to do is it's going to put it into the inbox. That's my default reminders list. So I just tap on inbox, and now you're going to see put together desk chair. So it doesn't keep track of the original list, just so you know. But all I have to do is just go and recover this, and then from there, I can tap on it and tap on the I over here, and I can go and put it in the list that I want. So that is what's new with calendars and reminders on the iPad with iPadOS 18. Probably the biggest thing is you can now see your reminders within the calendar app. I really like this. And it's really easy to do. Just add a date. We can add reminders from the Reminders app, add a date, it'll show up in calendar, or we can do it directly from the calendar app itself. So that's what's new with reminders and the calendar app on the iPad with iPadOS 18. Now, if you found the video helpful, make sure you give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends and family, and subscribe to my channel. You can also click on the bell within YouTube, and you'll get notified when I release a new video. It all helps. But also what you can do is you can check out my site, danstutorials.com. Although I have over 400 videos on YouTube, I have over 2,000 of them on my site. I've been working on my site a lot longer than I have been with YouTube. In addition to that, when you become a member of my site, this is how you can help support my efforts by becoming a member. What I do is I remove all of the ads on all of the videos. I also host webinars and classes on a regular basis, which you have access to. And I created an AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius that is available for members as well. So if you have a question, in a lot of cases, that AI assistant will be able to help you. And this is all included with my membership. But even more than that, when you become a member, you are helping support a small business. It is just me sitting in a corner office while I record these videos. I'm not part of some big corporation. So in addition to all those other benefits, just know that you're helping support a small business. So check out danstutorials.com for more information on that. And thanks for watching.